السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. ربي أعوذ بك من همزات الشياطين وأعوذ بك ربي أن يحضرون. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين أن ينزل عليكم من خير من ربكم، والله يختص برحمته من يشاء، والله ذو الفضل العظيم. البقرة verse number 105. ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين. Neither those who disbelieve among the people of the scripture. أهل الكتاب means people of the
scripture,
people of the book, that is the people of Moses and Jesus. ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين nor polytheists. ما يود الذين would not like to see. So the disbelievers, the people who disbelieve from amongst the people of the scripture and from amongst the polytheists, they would not like what? أَيُّنَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Any good ever bestowed upon you from your Lord. So they will not like the disbelievers from among the people of the scriptures and the idol worshippers. They will not like any good to be bestowed upon you, the people of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. والله يختص برحمته من يشاء. But Allah chooses for his mercy whom he intends, whom he wills. من يشاء. والله ذو الفضل العظيم. And Allah is limitless in his great bounty. It is فضل, mercy, blessings. Now, تفسير الكبير. In تفسير الكبير, تفسير الرازي, we see قوله تعالى ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين أن ينزل عليكم من خير من ربكم. This means فعلم أنه تعالى لما بين حال اليهود والكفار في العداوة والمعاندة حذر المؤمنين منهم فقال ما يود الذين كفروا فنفى عن قلوبهم الود والمحبة لكل ما يظهر به فضل المؤمنين. No. So, after describing the enmity, adawat means enmity, والمعاندت and arrogance or disobedience of the Jews and disbelievers, Allah wants the believers, wants the mu'mineen, once the people of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in this verse, ما يود الذين كفروا, that is, the disbelievers will not love, or the disbelievers from among the people of the scripture and from the idol worshippers will not like that there is little friendliness, that is, فنفى عن قلوبهم الود والمحبة, that is, there is little friendliness and love in their hearts toward all blessings that believers are bestowed with. So, you know, we have discussed in previous verses the enmity, the adawat, the enmity and mu'anadat, that is, the arrogance of the Jews. They used to say, that is, ra'ina, to take the attention of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he addresses the people. Okay, so instead of ra'ina, you use unnurna. Allah commanded the mu'minin, the believers. Why? Because the Jews addressed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ra'ina, in the means in the meaning that you as a fear, that is you a fool among us, fool among us, such a meaning is there. That is, it has got real meaning. But Ra'ina has got another harmless meaning, that is Ra'ina, you consider us. But the Jews used this word in the negative sense, that is you a fool among us, a shepherd among us, like that. So their enmity is revealed there. Their enmity towards the mu'mineen, towards Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is revealed there. So after describing the enmity and arrogance of the Jews towards the believers, here Allah describes what is there in the heart, what is there in their hearts. So they would not like any wahy or any blessings, any good to be revealed upon this Ummat, Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So here 2 points are there. Al-mas'alatul ula min al-ula lil-bayan li-anna alladhina kafaru jinsun tahtahu naw'an ahlul kitab wal-mushrikun. والدليل على قوله عليه قوله تعالى لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين من سورة البينة. So here الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين. So here الذين كفروا, those who disbelieve, means there are two groups of disbelievers here mentioned. Who are they? Who are the two groups? أهل الكتاب and the مشركين, the idol worshippers or the polytheists, and the Ahlul Kitab. Not all the members of Ahlul Kitab. Kafaru, alladhina kafaru min Ahlul Kitab. Those who disbelieve from among the people of the scriptures. Many or some of the people, some of the members of Ahlul Kitab, they followed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and embraced Islam as his coming, his advent was earlier prophesied in their scriptures, that is in Torah and in Injil. Okay. So some people followed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as they were commanded in their own scriptures. But some other people, they were arrogant, they were disobedient, they were jealous towards Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or towards the mu'minin, towards the believers. So there are two groups of people there. Disbelievers from among the scriptures, from among the people of the scriptures, and disbelievers or polytheists, Makkah Quraysh, polytheists. So in Surah Al-Bayyinah we see here, لَمْ يَكُنِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ وَلِلْمُشْرِكِينَ مُنْفَكِّينَ حَتَّى تَأْتِيَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَةِ. You recite those verses 1 to 6 of Surah Al-Bayyinah. لم يكن الذين كفروا
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم البينة
حتى تأتيهم البينة. No meaning.
Those who disbelieve from among the people of the scripture and the idolaters
were not going to leave until there came to them clear sense. Were not going to leave from their voices until there came to them clear signs. Rasulun min Allah yatlu suhfan mutahhara.
Rasulun min Allah yatlu suhfan mutahhara. A messenger from Allah reciting purified pages.
So hundreds of messenger of Allah came. They were not ready. They were not ready to, or they were in darkness. Okay. They were in darkness. They were not going to leave until there came to them clear signs by Allah, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulun min Allah yatlu suhfan mutahhara, reciting purified pages. Suhfan mutahhara.
Fiha kutubun qayyima.
Therein are upright books.
Yes.
وما تفرق الذين أوتوا الكتاب إلا من بعد ما جاءتهم البينة.
And the people of the scripture differed not until after there came to them the bayina.
Bayina means?
Clear
signs. Yes.
وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ فَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ.
And they were commanded not but that they should worship Allah, making religion purely for Him alone, Hunafa, and that they perform Salah and give Zakah, and that is the right religion.
And they were commanded not except that they should worship Allah, making religion purely for Him alone, مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ, turning away from all that is false, straightforward, hunafa, and that should perform salah, that is prayer, and give zakah, that is compulsory charity, and that وَذَٰلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ, and that is the right religion. So they, the people of the scriptures, were also commanded to follow these things, but many of them disobeyed, or many of them transgressed the limits. Then next verse,
Innal ladina kafaru min ahli alkitab wal mushrikeen fi nar jahannam khalidina fiha abadan
khalidina fiha. Stop there. Then
ulaika hum sharrul bariya.
Verily those who disbelieve from among the people of the scripture and the idolaters will abide in the fire of hell. They are the worst of creatures.
Yes. So they will abide in the hell of fire, the fire of hell. Why? Because they disbelieved in Allah. So verily, those who disbelieve from among the people of the scripture and the idol worshippers or polytheists, they will abide, they will dwell in the hell forever. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ شَرُّ الْبَرِيَّةِ, and they are the worst of the creatures. Bariya means
creatures.
So, المسألة الثانية, الخير. So, أَن يُنَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ خَيْرٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. أن ينزل ما يبد الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين. So the people of those who disbelieve from among the people of the book and the polytheist, they would never like to أن ينزل عليكم من ربكم, أن ينزل عليكم من خير من ربكم. That is, you are bestowed with any of the good. Any of goodness. So khair here means أَيُنَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Here khair means what? الْخَيْرُ الْوَحْيُ وَكَذَلِكَ الرَّحْمَةُ. So here goodness khair means wahy, that is divine revelation. وَكَذَلِكَ, and like that, الرَّحْمَةُ, the blessings from Allah. الرَّحْمَةُ يَدُلُّ عَلَيْهِ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. So here the proof is that أَهُمْ يَقْسِمُونَ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّكَ. In Surah Al-Zukhruf, Allah says, أَهُمْ يَقْسِمُونَ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّكَ نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَعِيشَتَهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَرَفَعْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ لِيَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا سُخْرِيَّةً وَرَحْمَةُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. أَهُمْ يَقْسِمُونَ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّكَ. Is it they who would portion out, or is it they who share or divide the mercy of your Lord? نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَعِيشَتَهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. It is we who portion out, or it is we who divide between them their livelihood, their livelihood. That is, ma'ishat, their income in this world. Wealth, property in this world is divided among the people by Allah Himself, not by the creatures themselves. Okay? And ورفعنا بعضهم فوق بعض درجات, and we raised some of them above others in ranks. Daraja means daraja,
rank,
rank or class, like that. And we raised some of the creatures or some of the people above some others. Okay, in darajas, in ranks. So in some ranks, some people will be better than others, or in some other ranks, some people will be better than others. Some will be wealthy, some will be poor, some will be healthy, some will be weak, like that. So it is Allah's plan. Not we are nothing to question it. We are none to question it. Okay, it is Allah's plan. Then لِيَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا سُخْرِيَّةً, so that some may employ others in their work. So some will be put under the custody of some others. So there will be wealthy people, there will be weak people, or poor people. So there will be employer and employee. So it is the plan of this universe or plan of this world. It is set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ, who will be better, the best among near Allah or on the day of judgment, it will be أَتْقَى, that is muttaqi, the pious people will be, whether he will be laborer or whether he will be employer, it is not the problem. The best people will be those who obey Allah's commands more. Okay, pious, piety, taqwa, atqaq. So, but the mercy of your rahmatu rabbika khayrum mimma yajma'un, but the mercy of your Lord is better than what they amass, what they collect, what they hoard. People, property, wealth, like that. So the mercy of Allah is better. So here, rahmat means mercy, blessings. So khair also means mercy or blessings. Here also divine revelation, wahy. So wahy, the advent of Prophet Muhammad or the advent of the final prophet was there or prophesied there in the previous scriptures. So they were awaiting the advent of this final messenger. But when he came, it was from the Arabs and not from the Israelites. So they were jealous. Many of them were jealous towards Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Arabs. Okay. And the Arab polities themselves, they were jealous towards Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers. So both of them are mentioned here. So when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came, he was from the Arabs. So many of the Israelites or Jews were not ready to accept, though they knew the truth. Okay. المعنى أنهم يرون أنفسهم أحق بأن يوحى إليهم. So that disbelievers were jealous towards Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فيحسدونكم وما يحبون أن ينزل عليكم شيء من الوحي. They were jealous towards Prophet believers, Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They themselves thought that they were more deserving to get that divine revelation or wahi. They were more deserving to get the final messenger from among themselves, from among the Israelites. So they were jealous towards the believers, Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ثم بين سبحانه أن ذلك الحسد لا يثر في زوال نعمتك. But then after describing their attitude, Allah affirms that their jealousy towards the believers will not cause to remove his blessings from this ummah. He will not remove. Zawal means removing. Zawal, mobile, we use the word zawal, moving. So his blessings from the believers will not be removed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the jealousy of the Jews. Okay. فإنه سبحانه يختص برحمته وإحسانه من يشاء because Allah indicates his blessings and favors upon whom he wills, he intends. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam.